गुरुवार की अनंत विश्व वृंद की श्री नवाचार्य हृदय ठाकुर की श्री अद्वैत श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपी श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिराज गोवर्धन की धाम की श्री निपणिहरि धाम की श्री श्री राधा मदन मोहन की श्री श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा महाराज की श्री श्री गौरीताई की गंगा मई की यमुना मई की भक्ति देव की श्रीमती तुलसी महाराज की जुगदा महिला
On behalf of Iskcon Atlanta, I'd like to welcome all the visiting devotees, guests, members, congregation members. There's anyone here for the first time coming? What's your good name?
Huh?
Jessica.
Jessica.
Jessica. So, where are you from? Atlanta, Georgia. Let's give a big hearty ball for Jessica. Anyone else here for the first time? Anyone else for the second time? Okay, so our next part of the program, we'll have a class. And today's Sunday feast lecture will be given by His Grace Adigadadhar Prabhu. He's the Bhakti Viksha director for our Metro Atlanta. And after the lecture, there will be a mini arati for the Sunday sponsors. And then, after there will be a little announcement, and then there will be prasadam for everybody. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Gopesha, Gopika Kanta, Radha Kanta,
Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
On behalf of Srila Prabhupada and our Iskcon of Atlanta, we welcome each and every one of you to our weekly Sunday Feast Festival. Thank you very much for coming. We will discuss one verse from Bhagavad Gita today. Chapter 2, entitled Contents of the Bhagavad Gita Summarized. Verse number 41. This is a very famous verse. So those of you who know, you can chant this verse with me. 2.41 Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is instructing Arjuna.
Vyavasayatmika bodhirekeha kurunandana bahushakha hyanantascha budhayo vyavasayina Vyavasayatmika bodhirekeha kurunandana bahushakha hyanantascha budhayo vyavasayina Vyavasayatmika bodhirekeha kurunandana bahushakha hyanantascha budhayo vyavasayina
Word to word synonyms. Vyavasaya atmika, resolute in Krishna consciousness. Buddhi, intelligence. Eka, only one. Iha, in this world. Kuru Nandan, O beloved child of the Kurus, Arjuna. Bahu Shakha, having various branches. He, indeed, Anantaha, unlimited. Cha, also, Budhaya, intelligence. A Vyavasayina, of those who are not in Krishna consciousness. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Prabhupada.
Jai
Shri Prabhupada. Translation. Those who are on this path are resolute in purpose and their aim is one. O beloved child of the Kurus, the intelligence of those who are irresolute is many branched. Purport. A strong faith that by Krishna consciousness one will be elevated to the highest perfection of life is called Vyavasayatmika, intelligence. The Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila, chapter 22, verse number 62 states Shraddha Shabde Vishayasa Kahe Sutrida Nischaya Krishne Bhakti Kaile Sarva Karma Krita Haya. Faith means unflinching trust in something sublime. What is the meaning of faith?
Unflinching trust in something
sublime. Yes, so faith means unflinching. Unflinching means that which cannot be shaken. Unflinching trust in something sublime. So, if someone has faith in one's own ability, if someone has trust in one's own ability, or in something mundane, can that be called as Shraddha? Can that be called as faith? No. Faith is trust in something which is sublime. When one is engaged in the duties of Krishna consciousness, he need not act in relationship to the material world with obligations to family traditions, humanity or nationality. Fruitive activities are the engagements of one's reactions from past good or bad deeds. When one is awake in Krishna consciousness, he need no longer endeavor for good results in his activities. When one is situated in Krishna consciousness, all activities are on the absolute plane and they are no longer subject to the dualities like good and bad. The highest perfection of Krishna consciousness is renunciation of the material conception of life. This state is automatically achieved by progressive Krishna consciousness. The resolute purpose of a person in Krishna consciousness is based on knowledge. Vasudeva sarvam iti sa mahatma sudurlabha. A person in Krishna consciousness is the rare good soul who knows perfectly that Vasudeva or Krishna is the root of all manifested causes. As by watering the root of a tree, one automatically distributes water to the leaves and branches, so by acting in Krishna consciousness, one can render the highest service to everyone, namely self, family, society, country, humanity, etc. If Krishna is satisfied by one's actions, then everyone will be satisfied. Service in Krishna consciousness is, however, best practiced under the able guidance of a spiritual master who is a bona fide representative of Krishna, who knows the nature of the student and who can guide him to act in Krishna consciousness. As such, to be well versed in Krishna consciousness, one has to act firmly and obey the representative of Krishna, and one should accept the instruction of the bona fide spiritual master as one's mission in life. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur instructs us in his famous prayers for the spiritual master as follows. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasado, yasya prasadam nagati kutopi, dhyayam stuvam stasya yashastri sandhyam, vande guru shri charanaravindam. By satisfaction of the spiritual master, the supreme personality of Godhead becomes satisfied. And by not satisfying the spiritual master, there is no chance of being promoted to the plane of Krishna consciousness. I should therefore meditate and pray for his mercy 3 times a day and offer my respectful obeisances unto him, my spiritual master. The whole process, however, depends on perfect knowledge of the soul beyond the conception of the body, not theoretically, but practically. When there is no longer a chance for sense gratification manifested in fruitive activities. One who is not firmly fixed in mind is diverted by various types of fruitive acts. Hare Krishna.
Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Tadalaye Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namaha.
Hare Krishna. So 3 days from now, there is a very important tithi. It is the appearance day, the birthday of a very great lady in our spiritual tradition. Her name is Srimati Gangamata Goswami. How many of you have heard of Gangamata Goswami? Very good. Very nice. So Gangamata Goswami, she appeared in the 17th century. She appeared in the 17th century and she was 3 generations after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And she appeared in Bengal. She was born as the daughter of a king in Bengal. The name of the king was Naresh Narayan. He was a king in Bengal and he had only one daughter. And
I know in Bangladesh.
Now it is in Bangladesh, correct? Yeah. Thank you. Arjun Prabhu is mentioning rightly that the birthplace of Gangamata Goswami in Bengal, today it is in Bangladesh.
It's called Rajshahi.
Huh?
Rajshahi city. Achha. Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. What is Rajshahi?
Rajshahi, that's a city.
Rajshahi is the city where she appeared. And it is in Bangladesh now, East Bengal. So from her early childhood, Gangamata Goswami, so her name, birth name was Sachi. Sachi. Okay, and from her childhood, Sachi was very, very devoted to Krishna. From her childhood, she used to read books like Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita. She was very much interested in Kirtan, Sankirtan. She was very interested in deity worship, Puja Archana, and she would always associate with devotees. When she came of age, naturally her parents wanted to find a suitable boy for her. You see, in those days in India, it was arranged marriage. So boys and girls would get married based on the arrangement of the parents. The parents would arrange. It was not how it is today. It was different in those days. This is the 17th century. So the parents would look for a suitable match. So when the time came for her to get married, her parents started looking for a suitable boy to get her married to. But Sachi told her parents that I have already given my heart to Krishna and I have accepted Krishna as my eternal husband. So please don't try to get me married to any person of this world, any man of this world. I'm not interested. I have already given my heart. So I want to live a life like that, devoted to Krishna, 100% devoted to Krishna. So what could her parents say? She was a mature girl and she had made her decision. So they supported her. And then as time went on, her devotion to Krishna only kept on increasing. And then somehow her father, Naresh Narayan Maharaj, king, he passed away. And soon after that, his wife, means Sachi's mother, also passed away. So now she was the only one in the royal family. She had no siblings, no uncles and aunties, and both her parents had passed away. So the whole responsibility of maintaining that kingdom fell upon this young lady, Sachi. But she had such good qualities. She was so trustworthy, she was so intelligent, she was so learned in all the scriptures, she was so wise, so compassionate, so responsible, so loving, that she performed her duties as the ruler of that kingdom very nicely. Very nicely. And for many years, she ruled like that. Even though she was a lady, she ruled without a husband, without a king. So she was the queen of that kingdom. After some years, her devotion to Krishna kept on getting deeper and more intense. And as it happens in the lives of most devotees, after a certain age, she developed a lot of renunciation. She wanted to just leave everything and devote herself 100% in the service of Krishna. She wanted to just give up everything, all other engagements, and 100% exclusively focus on Krishna consciousness. So she found a suitable person to rule the kingdom and she told everyone that now I want to travel to Odisha. I want to go to Jagannath Puri and I want to take darshan of Jagannath. It has been my lifelong desire to meet Jagannath. So please give me permission to go to Jagannath Puri. So everybody gave her blessings, gave her permission, and she appointed somebody else who was qualified to rule the kingdom, and alone she left from Bengal to Jagannath Puri. And she went to Jagannath Puri, and when she had darshan of our beloved Jagannath Baladeva Subhadra, she felt great ecstasy. And she decided, I will never leave Jagannath Puri. I will never leave Jagannath. So she stayed in Jagannath Puri. Every day she would come, take darshan of Jagannath. She would participate in Sankirtan. She would make garlands for Jagannath. She would assist in cooking in whatever way she could, bringing vegetables, bringing fruits. She would serve in the temple of Jagannath. And in this way, some time passed. She was living very blissfully in Jagannath Puri. And because Jagannath was very pleased with Sachi's devotion, simple devotion, he appeared to her and spoke to her in her heart. Just internally, she heard a voice of Jagannath. And Jagannath told Sachi that I am very pleased with your bhakti. I am very pleased with your devotion. Therefore, I want you to go to Vrindavan. Because when you go to Vrindavan, your bhakti will become stronger. And you will also find your guru in Vrindavan. So please proceed to Vrindavan. So Sachi, she immediately, next day, she left Jagannath Puri and she walked all the way from Jagannath Puri to Vrindavan, all alone. Through forests, through so many kingdoms, she went all alone. And she came to Vrindavan. When she came to Vrindavan, the six Goswamis of Vrindavan, they had already left this world. They had already left this world. And all the associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had disappeared. Because this is the 17th century now. So she came to Vrindavan. There were no buildings, roads in those days in Vrindavan. It was very rural. Just some simple Brajvasi villagers were living there. So she came. And she would go to different temples of the established by the Goswamis and take darshan. So she would go to Radha Madan Mohan temple, She would go to Radha Gopinath temple, she would go to Radha Raman temple, she would go to Bake Bihari temple, and she would go to Radha Govinda Dev temple, Radha Shyam Sundar temple, like that. And there the pujaris and the spiritual leaders would give Bhagavatam class every day. And she would hear from different devotees every day. One day, Sachi, she heard a Bhagavatam class given in the Radha Govinda Dev temple, Rupa Goswami's temple, by a devotee of the name Haridas Pandit. Now, a little history about Haridas Pandit. Who appeared as Srimati, who is the incarnation of Srimati Radharani in Gaur Lila? Gadadhar Pandit. So, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's associate is Gadadhar Pandit. Gadadhar Pandit lived in Jagannath Puri. On the order of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gadadhar Pandit became a guru. And he had many disciples. One of his prominent disciples, one of the prominent disciples of Gadadhar Pandit was Ananta Acharya. So Gadadhar Pandit is Radharani. And his prominent disciple was Ananta Acharya, who is an incarnation of Sudevi. Sudevi is one of the eight Sakhis, Ashta Sakhis. So one of the Ashta Sakhis, Sudevi, incarnated as Ananta Acharya and became a disciple of Gadadhar Pandit. Ananta Acharya had many disciples. And one of his prominent disciples was Haridas Pandit, who he sent to Vrindavan to serve Rupa Goswami's Radha Govinda Dev deities. So the head pujari of Radha Govinda Dev temple in Vrindavan was Haridas Pandit. When Sachi heard the lecture, the Bhagavatam class given by Haridas Pandit, her heart completely melted and she understood that this is my spiritual master. There are many devotees who have had this experience. We are looking for a guru, and then when we sit and hear from our guru, we see the activities of our Guru Maharaj, we make a decision in our heart that yes, this is my spiritual master. And then we give our life to our spiritual master. So that experience Sachi had when she saw Haridas Pandit. Because Haridas Pandit was the abode of all good qualities. He was very humble. He was extremely learned. He was a very expert pujari of Radha Govinda Dev. And at the same time, he was very pakka, very strong in Tattva Siddhanta. He really knew the philosophy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very well. And he was very expert at speaking Gaur Lila. So Sachi used to enjoy hearing Gaur Katha from Haridas Pandit. So when she decided that I want to take initiation from Haridas Pandit, she went to Haridas Pandit and told him that Gurudev, I have accepted you as my spiritual master. Please instruct me on what to do. Give me shiksha. Shiksha means instructions. So our acharyas explained this is very important. We should not go to our spiritual master just for diksha. Before diksha comes, shiksha. First we must learn to follow the instructions of Gurudev. Then we can expect to receive the mercy in the form of initiation. So Sachi Devi goes to Haridas Pandit and tells, give me instructions. Give me some orders. I want to follow your orders. Because I want to take shelter of your lotus feet. This is called Guru Padashraya. Rupa Goswami says the first step in spiritual life is Guru Padashraya. To take shelter of the spiritual master. Second stage is Guru Diksha. Receiving initiation. So Sachi took Guru Padashraya. She took shelter at the lotus feet of Haridas Pandit, her spiritual master. So this is what Haridas Pandit told her. It's very heartbreaking. He told her that Sachi Devi, you are a queen. He knew her history. Because you know, she was living in Vrindavan for many days and the word spreads. People talk, oh, this Mataji has come from Bengal. She used to be a queen. Then she gave up everything, went to Jagannath Puri. Then she has come to Vrindavan. So Haridas Pandit knew her background. So Haridas Pandit said, you are actually a queen. And look at your clothes. Look at this sari. You are wearing a silk sari. Look at your jewels and ornaments. You are so nicely decorated with expensive sari and expensive jewels. And this is Vrindavan. This is almost like a forest. It is not a city. It's very undeveloped, rural place. What will you do here? Vrindavan is not a place for a person like you. Vrindavan is not a place for queen. There is only one queen here and that is Radharani. So if you have this attitude, if you have this Rani Bhav, you have this attitude of a queen, then Vrindavan is not the right place for you. Vrindavan is a place to do bhajan. It is a place to execute devotional service. What devotional service will you execute wearing this expensive sari and these jewels? Sounds very harsh, right? Somebody has given up the kingdom, given up everything, and has come looking for Krishna, and you want initiation, want shiksha, and this is what you are telling. But actually it is not harsh. It is mercy. Gangamata, this Sachi Devi, she understood that actually my spiritual master is testing me. This is the instruction, that I must give up this expensive sari, I must give up this expensive opulent clothes and jewelry. So she understood. She immediately went and she begged for some rejected cloth. And some Brajvasis gave some rags to her. Cloths that were no good. They were rejects. So she picked up those rags. She covered herself nicely, decently, but not with fine, expensive clothes. With discarded clothes. She covered herself and she presented herself before Haridas Pandit. And every day without fail, she would come, sit and hear from Haridas Pandit. Again, our acharyas explained, this is very significant. It means the primary relationship between a disciple and a guru is through vani. Vapu, the physical body of the guru, may or may not be there. Our spiritual master may be in Mayapur. We may be in New Panajina. Physically, we are apart. But guru vani is available. If you go to Iskcon Desire, you go to YouTube, we can hear the lectures of our spiritual master. So the Shabda Brahma, the Vani is there. And the Sachi Devi is teaching us what is the primary relationship between a guru and a disciple? Hearing, submissively. What is that verse in Bhagavad Gita? Tad vidhi pranipatena pari prashnena sevaya upadyakshatite jnanam jnaninas tatva darshanam. So every day without fail, she would sit in her rags in the assembly in Radha Govindadev temple and hear every day without fail regularly from Haridas Pandit. When Haridas Pandit was satisfied that this girl, she comes and sincerely hears, he noticed her. If you see, even Srila Prabhupada had a similar experience. How many of you remember from Lilamrit? When Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur received Abhay Charan's name for initiation, when some senior disciples of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur recommended Prabhupada's name for initiation to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, what did Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur say? Yes, I have noticed him in the Vrindavan Parikrama. He likes to hear. He likes to hear. What had happened was, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was Simha Guru, Lion Guru. He was very powerful. He really knew how to cut into people's false ego. He took an assembly of devotees on Parikrama to Vrindavan. And everybody was expecting that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is going to talk about Ras Leela. He's going to talk about a 10th candle. And it was supposed to be a 30-day, 1-month Kartik Yatra. And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was going to lecture 3 hours in the morning and 3 hours in the evening, every day. So 60 lectures in 30 days. Each lecture of 3-hour duration. And first lecture on the first day in the morning, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur started with Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. The first verse of first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And he spoke. And then that day in the evening also he spoke on the same verse. Next day also same verse. Second day also same verse. All the 60 lectures, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur spoke on the first verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. When the disciples got restless, but he did not repeat anything. Everything he was talking about philosophy, tattva. No leela, just tattva. He was hammering the philosophy. And when disciples would get restless after 1 hour of hearing, you know, this heavy philosophy, some of them approached him and asked him, Prabhupada, because he was called Prabhupada, Prabhupada, what is this? We have come to Vrindavan Parikrama to hear some sweet Krishna Katha, and you are just talking heavy philosophy day after day. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said that first you must understand tattva, then you can understand leela. In tattva there is leela, and in leela there is tattva. But how to realize that? That requires intelligence, he said. So he said, you sit and hear. So what happened was, one day he was giving a class, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, and in some temple, darshan opened. So the news spread that darshan has opened, so those who want to take darshan, you can leave the class and go take darshan and come back. So everybody left. There were only 3 devotees who waited, sat there and heard from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. One of them was Abhay Babu, our Prabhupada. So Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur years later remembered that yes, this Abhay Babu, he likes to hear. He likes to hear. So yes, I will initiate him. And Bhakti Siddhanta Sarath Thakur gave first and second initiation at the same time to Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki
jai!
So the relationship of a disciple with the Guru is through hearing carefully and then following the instructions that we hear in the lecture. So when Haridas Pandit was satisfied with Sachi, that she comes regularly, hears attentively with an erect back, without falling asleep, he became happy. So he gave her second shiksha, second instruction. Do you want to know what the second instruction was?
Hello.
Second instruction was that I have a female disciple, her name is Lakshmi Priya. I want you to become friends with her and associate with her. Haridas Pandit told Sachi, go and make friendship with this girl, her name is Lakshmi Priya, she is my disciple. Okay? Now this is the order of spiritual master. So she immediately goes to Lakshmi Priya. And she introduces herself and says that Guru Maharaj has said that I should associate with you. So Lakshmi Priya is very happy. She accepts her as her own sister and they embrace. And then Lakshmi Priya says, from today you live with me. I am also like you only, I don't have a fixed place to stay. I live on the banks of Radhakund, sometimes near Govardhan. And I am also wearing rejected rags like you. All my only possession is my japmala. So he said, we will both live like sisters. You also do japa, I will also do japa. So Sachi asks Lakshmi Priya, how many rounds do you chant? How many rounds do you chant? So Lakshmi Priya says, I chant 192 rounds minimum every day, 3 lakhs. You have to follow in the footsteps of Haridas Thakur, she says. So both these ladies, both these Matajis, Sachi and Lakshmi Priya, from that day, Sachi starts chanting 192 rounds of japa every day. When their japa is complete, they go on Madhukari. Whatever Vraja roti is given to them, they eat that once a day. Eating only once a day. You got background music. So only eating once a day. And then they would go on Govardhan Parikrama every day together. Lakshmi Priya and Sachi Devi. They would come, they would take bath after Govardhan Parikrama and Radhakund Shyamkund. And evening they would come for the Bhagavatam class of Haridas Pandit. This was their schedule. They would go to Vamshivat, they would go to Rasasthali, and Lakshmi Priya would tell different pastimes. Take her on like Vrindavan Parikrama. And in this way, Sachi, she blossomed like anything in the association of Lakshmi Priya. My dear friends, this is very important. If we want to make advancement in Krishna consciousness, we have to choose our friends very carefully. Because association of Guru Maharaj, association of Guru Gan is not always available. We have to associate with different types of devotees. We cannot just associate with Guru. I will only associate with my Guru, I will not associate with anybody else. That doesn't work. So there are three types of devotees in our society, in ISKCON. One is our Guru Gan, our Shiksha Gurus and our Diksha Guru. They are at a very elevated platform. We should hear from them regularly. Whenever we have an opportunity, we must hear from them. And then we do our outreach. We have our Bhakti Vrikshas where we and temple programs where we reach out to others, and whatever happiness, whatever ananda, whatever bliss we have received in Krishna consciousness, naturally we want to share it with others. That this has really worked for me, it has made me more peaceful, less angry, you know, it has really improved my health, my life. So please take to Krishna consciousness. Follow these four regulative principles, chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This is outreach. So when we do outreach, we associate with devotees who don't know much about this path of spirituality, Krishna consciousness. That is the second type. And third type of association is associating with like-minded friends like us. So we have higher association, we have outreach, and we have friendship. All three types of sangha, all three types of association is essential. We have to balance nicely. Because of association with Lakshmi Priya, Sachi Devi's spiritual life took off like anything. She started chanting 192 rounds, Govardhan Parikrama every day, Radha Kunda Snan every day, hearing Bhagavatam class every day. And she was so blissful, they would always talk about Bhagavatam, discuss Chaitanya Charitamrit together, both of them. They were blissful. Blissful, doing Madhukari together, having little Vraja Roti together every day. They were so blissful. And hearing from Guru Maharaj every day together. Very perfect life. Then, when Haridas Pandit saw that this girl, Sachi, is really very nice. She's very serious. She's following the path nicely. She has made very good loving friendship with Lakshmi Priya after my instructions, he said, I will initiate you. And he initiated her, and Sachi became Sachi Devi. And then Sachi Devi and Lakshmi Priya, they had a very good friendship, and they spent few years blissfully together in Krishna consciousness in Vrindavan. Then one day Haridas Pandit called both of them, and he told Sachi Devi that I want you to leave Vrindavan. Now just see, everything was so perfect in Vrindavan. They are so happy. They had found shelter in Vrindavan, in Vrajadham. And now Guru Maharaj is saying, I want you to leave Vrindavan. And I want you to go to Jagannath Puri today itself. Go to Jagannath Puri today. Leave for Jagannath Puri today. So she says, what is the mission in Jagannath Puri for me? What are the instructions for me? So Haridas Pandit says, there lived a great devotee in Jagannath Puri. You know, his name is Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. After Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left this world, Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and Ramananda Rai would sit in the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, and day and night they would discuss Gaur Katha, and they would cry in separation from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This went on for some time, and then in great separation from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, both of them left this world. And Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya's wife also left this world. Since then, the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya is in utter ruins. It is not being maintained. And in that house is the personal worshipable deity of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. A very beautiful Shaligram Shila. Here we have Mataji, Leela Krishna Prabhu's beloved mother. She is coming from Nepal. Let us welcome her by three times loudly chanting Hari Bol.
Hari Bol!
Shaligram Shilas are found in Nepal, in the Gandaki River, in Muktinath. So, Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya had a Shaligram Shila that he had worshipped for years and years and decades with his own loving hands. And this Shaligram Shila was a Damodar Shaligram Shila. And this Damodar Shaligram Shila was lying in the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya without receiving any worship. And in his own meditation, in his own divine trance and vision, Haridas Pandit understood this. So he told Gangamata Goswami, who's Sachi Devi, he told Sachi Devi, you go to Jagannath Puri and take over the service of that Shaligram Shila of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. And if possible, repair the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. Sachi Devi says, she bows down and she says, I will do as you say. Today's verse of Bhagavad Gita, Vyavasaya Atmika Buddhi, Eke Hai Guru Nandana. A true disciple is one who is one pointedly focused on the mission of Gurudev. Her Guru Maharaj gave her a mission. What was the first instruction? Give up your opulent clothes. She did that. Second was, associate with Lakshmi Priya. She did that. Third instruction is, go to Jagannath Puri and renovate the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya and establish proper standards of worship for the beloved Shaligram Shila of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. She said, I will do it. Then she goes and takes the blessings of all the Brajvasis, all the Goswamis, temples, all the Pujaris. She goes, takes their blessings. She takes the blessings of all the deities of Vrindavan. Radha Raman, Radha Govindadev, Radha Gopinath, Radha Madan Mohan. She takes blessings and then she embraces Lakshmi Priya. They are both weeping with the pain of impending separation. They were best friends, but now they are going to be separated, probably for the rest of their lives. In those days, no cell phones, no letter, nothing. No communication, nothing. And they're so far away, Vrindavan and Jagannath Puri. So they bid their farewell to each other very painfully. And then alone, Sachi Devi walked all the way back to Jagannath Puri. And she came to the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. And when she entered the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya, it was in shambles. It was in utter ruins. So, you know, the walls were falling, the roof was falling, there were cobwebs, there was dust everywhere. It was a very pitiable condition, and the Shaligram Shila was lying on a broken down altar covered with dust and cobwebs. It was very, very painful. And when she went inside that house, she remembered that this is the house where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first came to Jagannath Puri, and he had darshan of Jagannath. He became unconscious in ecstasy, and Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya had brought Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to his own house. This is the house where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had recovered from his ecstasy. This is the house where he discussed with Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. This is the house where he instructed Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and delivered him and made him a pure devotee. This is the house in which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had spoken of the meaning of the Atmaram verse. This is the house in which Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and his wife would regularly invite Chaitanya Mahaprabhu for prasad. This is that house. This is the house in which Amodh, the son-in-law of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, was delivered from the cholera of his envy. She started remembering all these wonderful pastimes that she had only heard in Vrindavan about. Now she is there in that dham, in this holy place of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's house. She was filled with ecstasy. At the same time, she was filled with anxiety. How will I carry out the orders of my spiritual master? I am alone. I am a lady. I don't have any followers. I don't have any sponsors. I don't have any money. I have no means. How am I going to establish the worship of Shaligram Shila? In those days, Mataji were not even allowed to worship Shaligram Shilas. Because in Skanda Puran, both statements are there. It is said that you should not worship. And Shivji also says, you should worship, you can worship. Everybody can worship. But our merciful Srila Prabhupada, he has opened all the services to everybody, regardless of your body. Male body, female body, doesn't matter. Everybody can become pujari. Our head pujari is Govardhan Lila Mataji. Our assistant is Kamalakshi Radhika Mataji. So Prabhupada is very, very merciful. And the praman, the Shastri praman is Gangamata Goswami. She became the sole pujari of the Shaligram Shila, of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. But she was overwhelmed with anxiety. How is it going to happen? Slowly, slowly, it took a lot of time. People saw her genuine devotion. They saw how she would chant 3 lakh names every day. How she would worship so selflessly. And slowly, slowly, she started getting followers, well-wishers. They gave donations. And slowly, bit by bit, she renovated the entire house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and restored it to the previous glory. And she established very high standards for Shaligram Seva, the Damodar Shaligram Shila. That Shila would be offered fresh bhoga, that she would cook with her own loving hands. Fresh tulsi leaves, tulsi manjaris, flowers, everything was being offered to that Shaligram Shila very nicely. And then, in the evening, she would give Bhagavatam class in the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. And so many devotees would come and hear. When the king of Orissa heard that a Vaishnavi came from Vrindavan and she has renovated the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, she has re-established the proper standards of worshipping the Shaligram Shila of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and she is giving wonderful Bhagavata classes every day in the evening, he developed a desire to come and hear from her. So the king of Bengal in the 17th century, his name was Mukunda Dev Maharaj. Raja Mukunda Dev, he came to the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya in the evening one day to hear the Bhagavatam class. And he sat down and he heard from Sachi Devi. And he had the same experience that Sachi Devi had when she heard first time from Haridas Pandit. He, the king, he developed a desire that I should accept her, Sachi Devi, as my Diksha Guru, as my spiritual master. So he approached her and she said, "What are you saying? I am just an ordinary lady. How can I become your guru? You are the king of Orissa. I cannot accept this honor." So she declined. And the king went away. And then the king, he came back after some time again to hear Bhagavatam class from her. And this time he was so filled with ecstasy, he offered her, "At least take some dakshina and at least accept a piece of land as a token of my love and appreciation for you." But again she declined. He said, "There is no place for devotees to sit in your Bhagavatam class. This house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya is too small. There are hundreds of devotees who want to hear from you. Come, let me make a big temple for you. And you can give class to hundreds of thousands of devotees there." She said, "No, this is fine." Then what happened was, one day, she had a desire to take a bath in Ganga. Ganga Snan. Why? Because it was Ganga Sagar Mela Tithi day, very holy day. So she had a desire to take a bath in Ganga Devi. But she is in Jagannath Puri. Ganga is far away. So she just had this desire, but then she said, "It's okay, I am in a holy place, I am in Jagannath Puri. I will just be happy here." But that night, Jagannath came in her dream. Jagannath came in the dream of Sachi Devi. And he told her, "My dear Sachi Devi, since your childhood you have accepted me as your husband. You have given your heart and your life to me. Do you think I cannot fulfill this one desire? Right now I will tell Ganga Devi to come. and fulfill your desire to take Ganga Snan. So you go. There is a kund in Jagannath Puri. It is called Shweta Kund. Go to Shweta Kund and take a bath. That water will be filled with the water of Holy Mother Ganga tonight. Go and take a bath. And then Jagannath tells the story of this Shweta Kund in Jagannath Puri. Jagannath ji tells Sachi Devi that Indradumna Maharaj established this temple of mine in Satya Yuga. In Treta Yuga, among his descendants was a king whose name was Maharaj Shweta. And he was a very humble, very nice devotee of mine. And every day he would cook for me and bring a bhoga cooked by his own loving hands and offer it to me. So please, Prabhujis who think that we should not know how to cook, that is wrong. In this story we can learn that the king of Orissa, Shweta, Maharaj Shweta, he himself used to cook for Jagannath every day and bring bhoga offerings. So one day he cooked something simple and he brought for Jagannath. And as he was giving it for offering, he had a vision. And he saw that the different devatas, different demigods have come in their subtle bodies and they have cooked bhoga for Jagannath because Jagannath loves to eat. And they are offering what they have cooked to Jagannath and Jagannath is eating. So he, King Shweta, he felt extremely humbled that here I have made some simple bhoga for Jagannath. When he is being fed by the topmost demigods, Shivji is cooking, Brahmaji is cooking, Indradev is cooking and bringing, Suryadev is cooking for Jagannath and feeding him. What is the value of my offering? He felt extremely dejected, extremely humbled, but somehow he just kept his offering and went away, very humbled. So that night when he was sleeping, Jagannath came in his dream, in the dream of Maharaj Shweta, and told him, "Why are you lamenting? Right now, open the door of the temple and come inside. In fact, I will open the door for you. Come and meet me right now." So in his sleep, Maharaj Shweta wakes up and he runs to Jagannath temple. And he goes inside and what does he see? That the bhoga that he had brought for Jagannath, Lakshmi Devi, with her own loving hands, she has picked up that plate and with her own hands, she is feeding Jagannath. And Jagannath is eating. Jagannath is eating that what was cooked by Maharaj Shweta. When Shweta sees this vision, he becomes very blissful, very ecstatic. And he falls down, offering his obeisances, shedding tears of love. And he says, thank you, Jagannath, for accepting my offering, my humble offering. Jagannath says, I am accepting your offering every day. In fact, I don't eat it in front of the demigods. I eat it in solitude because I want to relish the taste of your bhakti in your bhoga. Therefore, I tell Lakshmi Devi to feed me what you have cooked. So please don't have any doubt that I am not accepting your prasad. I am accepting it, don't worry. Then Jagannath says, ask me for two benedictions. Ask me for two benedictions. So Maharaj Shweta says, the first benediction I want is, let my life be a life of service to you. Let me do whatever you want me to, like your puppet. Make me your puppet. Make me do with my body, mind and words whatever is pleasing to you. And at the end of this life, the second benediction, when I die, if it is your desire, then please bring me to your eternal abode, Goloka Vrindavan. Please give me this benediction. So Jagannathji says, Tathastu. Your life will be an offering to me. You will do what is pleasing to me. And at the end of your life, I will personally take you to the spiritual world. So this King Shweta, he lived a long life of devotion. And at the end of his life, when he departed, Jagannath himself took him to the spiritual world. So the place where Maharaj Shweta left this world, the place where he departed from, that place, naturally a kund was formed. A small pond was formed. And Jagannath revealed to the pujaris that the water in this pond represents my mercy on King Shweta. So this water is my mercy in liquid form. So take bath here, everybody, you will be purified. So that is the history of Shweta Kund. So Jagannath is telling Sachi Devi in her dream, we are back to Sachi Devi, that go and take bath in that Shweta Kund. And today, tonight, the water will be filled with Ganga. Go and take a bath. So on the auspicious occasion of Ganga Sagar Mela, Sachi Devi wakes up at night, in the middle of the night, and goes and takes her bath in Shweta Kund. As soon as she enters the water, Mother Ganga by the touch of another great pure devotee like Sachidevi, she goes in ecstasy. And she tells her that I originate from the lotus feet of Jagannath, right? Ganga Devi, she washed the feet of Krishna. That's why she's so pure. So she says, I originate from the lotus feet of Jagannath. So I have an intense desire. First time I have come to Jagannath Puri. I have an intense desire to go to my constitutional position, to the lotus feet of Jagannath. So here I go and I'm taking you with me. So Ganga Devi embraces Sachi Devi and together the water surges like a flood and it goes all the way from Shwetakund to the temple of Jagannath Puri inside the inner sanctum sanctorum. Right where Jagannath Balaram Subhadra are and goes and washes the lotus feet of Jagannath. And suddenly the villagers of Jagannath Puri, they wake up that there is a flood on the road from Shwetakund along the road to Jagannath Puri temple. Nowhere else, just like a river has formed. So they all wake up and they are worried that Jagannath will be flooded. So they open the temple in the middle of the night to rescue Jagannath. And what do they see? They see that the water has gone and stopped at the lotus feet of Jagannath. And there on the altar is sitting Sachi Devi. So the head pujari becomes very angry. He says, what is this? This Mataji has entered the temple inside at night. Maybe she has come to steal the jewelry of Jagannath. Because she has so many projects to fulfill. Her Gurudev has told her to renovate the house of Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya. Maybe she needs funds for that. So she has come to steal. Like that, you know, they start accusing her. Crazy things. And they say, let's put her in jail. So believe it or not, Sachi Devi, who is such a great devotee, is put behind bars. She is imprisoned, incarcerated. Because she entered Jagannath's temple illegally, without permission. And there was allegation that she was trying to steal the jewelry of Jagannath. And then they put her in prison and they go back to sleep. All the guards and the police and the head pujari. That night, as soon as they go to sleep, Jagannath comes in the dreams of the head pujari and the dream of the king, Mukunda Dev, who is still aspiring for initiation. Jagannath comes in their dream, both their dreams, and he gives them four instructions. He says, I am so displeased with this head pujari. He has offended such a great Vaishnavi. I had told Ganga Devi to bring her to me. And she had come there with my permission, with my arrangement. And you fools, you have put her behind bars. Immediately go and release her. And these are my four instructions for you. Number one, fall at the lotus feet of Sachi Devi and beg forgiveness for what you have done. Jagannath is teaching us when we commit Vaishnava, this is what we have to do. We have to understand our mistake, beg forgiveness from the Vaishnava that we have offended. Second benediction says, both of you beg for initiation from Sachi Devi. And if she refuses, tell her that it is my order that she should initiate both of you. Third instruction, every day, and this is specially for the king, Mukunda Dev, he says, every day, Jagannath is telling her, every day, the Rajbhog offering that happens to me, you must take it personally to Sachi Devi and give her my Mahaprasad every day. And fourth instruction, you must donate to her a piece of land that is right adjoining to Shwetakund. Give her that piece of land. So immediately the king comes, wakes up, goes to the jail. The head pujari wakes up, goes to the jail. They open the jail and they release Sachi Devi. They fall at her lotus feet, they beg forgiveness, they beg her for initiation, and the king says, I will make sure that you get Jagannath's Mahaprasad every day. And they say that this piece of land is yours, right next to Shwetakund. And when she declines out of her humility, they say, this is the order of Jagannath. He came in our dream and he has told us, now you cannot refuse. Now you have to accept us as your disciples. Imagine, the letter of recommendation is coming from Jagannath for the initiation of Mukunda Dev Maharaj. How fortunate. So then, after they are initiated, Mukunda Dev Maharaj, he asks his spiritual master, Sachi Devi, that why did this horrible incident happen? How could the head pujari and the police put you behind bars? It pains me. How did this happen? So Sachi Devi laughs. And she says, this is all pastimes of Jagannath. He is doing it for his own enjoyment. And then she says, if this would not have happened, you would have never got initiation. So see, we can very difficult to understand the plans of Krishna. How he can do so many things through his different leelas. So anyway, the king becomes a disciple, the head pujari becomes a disciple, and she takes over that land, piece of land, and she builds a big temple there, where she gives lectures every evening to hundreds of thousands of devotees in Jagannath Puri. And that kund, Shweta Kund, was renamed as Shweta Ganga Kund. Why? Because the water was filled with the water of Ganga. So it became Shweta Ganga Kund. It is still there in Jagannath Puri. How many of you have been to Shweta Ganga Kund? Some devotees have gone. Mataji has gone. Very nice. So this is the story of Gangamata Goswamini. And then after this incident, she was renamed as Gangamata Goswamini. Why? Her name was Sachi Devi, but she was named Ganga Mata Goswami. Why? Ganga Mata because Ganga Devi herself came to fulfill her desire of Ganga Snan. She had a desire to take bath in Ganga, and Ganga Devi herself came, embraced her, and delivered her to the lotus feet of Jagannath. So she was called Ganga Mata Goswamini because her senses were completely controlled. Goswamini, Ganga Mata Goswamini. So her appearance day is coming in 3 days. So we thought we will discuss, because just now we celebrated Jagannath Rath Yatra. So this pastime is intimately connected with Jagannath also.
Thank you. Thank you.
which will take place tomorrow noon. Yes?
No? 1 o'clock.
1 o'clock.
Yes.
Okay. So they're saying we are inviting all the devotees, please come and they take part in the marriage ceremony, and there will be prasadam, there will be chanting Hare Krishna mantra, there will be kirtan. So you all can come and take part in this marriage ceremony. It's very auspicious and can give your blessings to the married couple. So Santa Chaitanya Prabhu, he has been coming to this temple for almost 3 years. And he's been doing a lot of seva to this temple. He's actually regularly coming here and staying at least 4 days a week, staying in the temple, doing some seva. And as you heard from Adigadadhar, our Bhakti Bhiksha director, how they're leading the Bhakti Bhiksha program, I think every Saturday and also on Thursday. Yeah. So they're doing this seva very nicely. And as you know, Bhakti Vinod Thakur, one of our acharya, the predecessor, he mentioned that the Krishna consciousness can be preached and it can be reached to all the people through the Bhakti Bhiksha program or through the Nanamata program. So one of our present acharya, His Holiness Jayapatra Sai Maharaj, he's doing this seva in Mayapur, India, in West Bengal very nicely. And also in our new Panyahari Dham, we are also doing this seva. And as you know, Adigadadhar Prabhu and many other devotees, Bhakti Bhiksha leaders like Sadhu Shaitanya Prabhu, Kamalakshi Mataji, and they are doing this seva very nicely. To please Guru and Guranga. So, and Kamalakshi Mataji also, she's been trained here, she got initiated also, and she also joined this temple. She joined this temple. So let's give a big Hari Bol for Kamalakshi Mataji. Newly married also in this temple. So, it's a mercy of Gauranga and Nithyananda. It's a really special blessing of Gauranga Mahaprabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nithyananda Prabhu. So now, no doubt that Kamalakshi Mataji, she's trying best to please Guru and Krishna and all the devotees. And she's been serving this Atlanta New Manyani Dham for a long time. She went to Mayapur for a couple of years and she served there also. Now she's again back in Atlanta and she's doing her service to Srila Prabhupada and his mission and his Guru Maharaj. So we're really also thankful to all of the family members who have come for this wedding ceremony. Very nice. So let's give a big Hari Bol for all these devotees who have come.
Hari Bol!
I would like to thank everyone here that you gave us your blessings, and please you're all invited tomorrow so that we can get more blessings because we'll need it throughout our life. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Festival. So, by the blessing of Srila Prabhupada, Radha Madan Mohan Shri Gaurindai and Jagannath Balasubhadra Maharani. We had a great, grand, successful festival for last week on Saturday and Sunday, both days. So we'd like to especially thank all the devotees actually who participated. As you know from the Ramchandra's history, Lord Ramachandra's history, that even a small pearl, he was putting a little sand in the ocean and he was trying to build a bridge for Lord Ramachandra. So anyone who helped this festival, whether in a bigger scale or a smaller scale, but all of your help made this festival very wonderful and everybody enjoyed it. So let's give a thank to all the Panihati devotees and congregations, all the well-wishers. Hari Bol! And we especially like to thank our Bhakti Viksha leaders, directors for these special festivals, and also to the management of Iskcon Atlanta to have such a nice festival. Approximately we raised almost $75,000. And we also expend almost $50,000. But we'll give you update next coming Sunday how much we really spend and how much we really got the donation from the devotees. So, and because we're supposed to do it, but some other our temple president, he had to do something urgent, so he couldn't come. So next Sunday we'll do it. And also, we like to thank especially Ganga Mataji and Adigadadhar Prabhu and Geeta Mataji for their special donation towards this Rath Yatra festival. So everyone please raise your hand and say big Hari Bol for these three wonderful devotees. Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Thank you very much. So now we'll have final darshan of the deities and the prasadam will be served outside. Thank you. Hare Krishna.